Married to cops. It's Love in the Line of Duty, next to Geraldo.
This is a joke, right?
Would I do that to you?
Yeah, you most certainly would. This kind of humor is right up your alley to have this printed.
You know, you're so cynical. I admit, I arranged this as a surprise, but not as a joke. Thank you, Charles.
Thank you. It has to be.
Why?
Why? Gee, Kirk, I don't know. I know one thing. Lisa would not let you take her restaurant, which is named Diana's, and just change the name to Ellie's.
You're right. That's why I had to buy it.
Buy what?
The whole yacht. So, let's drink up, shall we? I think we should toast your namesake, and then we'll go break a magnum over the prow of the newly christened M-Y-L-E-S.
What do you mean your van is gone?
Where'd you leave it?
Right out front in the driveway.
Were the keys in it?
Yeah, but not in the ignition. I left it under the floor mat like I always do.
Honey, you better report this right away.
Yeah, I will as soon as Bob gets off.
Why were you so upset when John said he'd given Susan 2 weeks vacation?
Because she shouldn't be off somewhere by herself right now.
Why? Why not?
Yeah, Hogan. It's Hughes. I want to report a stolen vehicle. What's the license plate number?
VYF-639.
VYF-639.
You know, Andy didn't have any wheels. He knows what Duke keeps his keys like that. Maybe Andy took the van.
No, no, I think you're reaching, John.
Audio temporaries work for the best companies. They're confident because they know where they're going. And they can think on their feet. Making friends comes easily. And people pay attention to an audio temporary. Call Audio today, and you could be working tomorrow. Audio, temporary and permanent employment. 1,400 offices worldwide.
For
a free toy?
There is none.
Did you take it?
There's no toy in Kix.
No marshmallows either.
No.
No candy things.
No.
How come you like it?
Try it.
Kids like Kix because of its crisp corn crunch. Moms like Kix because it's low in sugar.
Now what are you looking for?
I dropped one.
Kix, kid tested, mother approved.
For something light, may we suggest a cool McDonald's salad. Toss fresh, they go to work, to your home, to the park, to the beach. Crisp, delicious salads right in reach. Fresh tossed salads from McDonald's, oh yeah, all dressed up and ready to go.
With Woolite, now you can be sure your couch is clean when company drops in. Woolite Upholstery Cleaner. It safely lifts out tough dirt and grime so you're always ready for the unexpected. No fooling. Woolite, it's serious cleaning.
Okay, thanks. All right, the report will go out to every car on duty in Oakdale and the state, please.
Great, thanks. I can't imagine who'd want to steal old Rosie, though. Sorry, I can take a rain check on that van ride.
No sweat. It's weird, though. I mean, we're just out there looking at the van like 15 minutes.
Yeah, this whole thing is weird.
I still think there's a possibility that Andy took that van.
Well, I told John I thought he was reaching. He doesn't seem to want to listen to me.
I know the feeling. He practically lives here now. I guess we won't get rid of him until we find out what happened to Andy.
You know, hearing all these stories about Andy cashing bad checks and stealing jewelry from the girl that he was staying with, it just makes me realize how desperate he must be.
Yeah, I know. Courtney, we better go.
Okay.
Sean, can we wait till Leanne gets here? Duke said something about the three of us going out for pizza.
It'd be nice for Courtney to get to know Leanne a little better.
Well, I'm not going to argue with the two most important women in my life.
John, did Susan say where she was going on this vacation?
No, she didn't, Bob, but then I didn't ask her. No.
Excuse me.
Hey, maybe that's a cop's call and say they found my van.
Hello. No, hi, Lisa. No, I'm afraid there's no news about Andy.
No, I was so hoping you would have heard something by now.
Hello, beautiful.
Look, Kim, would you please let me know the minute
Andy's
you hear
missing and nobody knows where he is.
All right. Is there anything I can do? Just please let me know. Bye. Bye-bye. Hi, Kim.
Hi, Lisa.
Oh, poor Kim is just so upset. Usually she is so on top of everything, and now this situation with Andy, the whole thing is just out of control. I wish the boy would come to his senses and just call his mother.
Yeah, me too. I feel responsible for all
this. Julie, don't do that to yourself.
Well, I do. But now Caleb is right. You shouldn't. Look, if you blame yourself, that's not going to help Andy. Look, we're really slow tonight. Why don't you just sit down and have a nice dinner with your handsome husband?
You sure you don't mind?
I'm sure.
Okay. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Lisa.
Good evening, Lisa.
Duncan, hi. Wait a minute, what's wrong with you? Look at your boots.
I just put Shannon on a plane to Philadelphia. Aww.
Well, how's her brother? How'd the operation go?
Well, the surgery went well, but it left him partially paralyzed, so she felt she should be with him. I was going to go with her, but I don't know, I probably just would have been in the way. So, I feel a bit strange, this being the first night without my bonnie bride since our wedding last November.
Well, you've come to the right place, you know. I will, buy you a drink.
Sounds good.
Hello, welcome back. Any word about Barbara?
It was all dead ends, even Emily's attempt to get more out of Visconti than he was willing to give me.
Yeah, when'd you get in?
Well, we flew back together just now, and Tao was nice enough to invite me for some dinner.
Good, come this way.
How about a drink, huh?
Yeah, you know something? I think I'd like a glass of white wine.
All right.
And I think that I would like a beer.
You got it.
Thank you.
I need a glass of white wine and one beer.
Hello.
Hi.
Is there any news on Andy?
No, I just talked with Kim. No word yet. Oh, Hal just came in.
He did? Great. I was expecting him tonight, but I didn't know that
he
was back
yet. Well, he's here, and he's over there with Emily.
No, there's no more news on Andy.
Well, I was keeping Leanne. I mean, she got off from the castle, said she was leaving right away. She'd be here by now.
Well, just be happy she's not speeding. She'll be here shortly.
Just as soon as I possibly can. Right. Okay, goodbye.
I gotta get back to the house. Will you call me if you hear anything with Andy?
Of course I will, of course.
I'm sure he'll call you before he does me.
So why don't we put some sandwiches up?
Okay. Right. I'll help you. Thank you.
Hello. Yes, just a minute. Margo, state police for you.
Oh, maybe they found your van, apprehended the thief already.
Yeah, wouldn't that be nice?
Hughes.
Hello, Captain Harris here. The van you reported stolen, it was just involved in a head-on out on Riverside Highway. Are you by any chance related to Tom Hughes, the DA?
Yes, he's my husband. Why? Yes, she's my daughter, too. Leanne has been involved in an accident.
You don't need an invitation to know she wants you there. You don't need a reason to let her know you care. You don't need to say a word to tell her that she's great. All you need is to show her how to celebrate.
Swiss Mocha, a chocolate-flavored coffee from General Foods International Coffee.
Celebrate the moments of your life.
The people of Wyawega, Wisconsin do not make things too quickly, nor do they make things too fancy. But they have been known to make the big play And they're becoming quite well known for making spreadery, a delicious cheese snack. Spreadery comes in 7 flavors, and it now comes in microwavable tubs, so it goes with just about everything. Spreadery cheese snack from Kraft. The good news from Wyawega is spreading fast.
I won't wear anything without Cross Your Heart, because great looks start with Cross Your Heart. With crisscross shaping, I always look better.
The Cross Your Heart bra. Great looks start with Cross Your Heart from Playtex.
The fit that makes the fashion.
Oh, hi, Anne. Listen, I've only got a minute, but I can talk. I'm just cleaning.
New Pine Sol Spruce Ups, the pre-moistened cleaner in a cloth. They clean, wipe, and dry in one stroke. Free up your day. Spruce up with Spruce Ups in lemon or fresh scent.
If you've ever wondered where it will end, you're about to find out.
It'll be the last game between me and Sharp.
The final 4 episodes of Falcon Crest begin.
He has my home address.
Then an obsessed fan.
Some weirdo's after my wife.
Wants to love Karen.
This is creepy.
To death. Knots Landing, all Thursday.
So, you own the entire yacht?
Absolutely. Hmm?
That's what all those furtive phone calls to Lisa and Shannon were all about. Mm-hmm. I was worried they wouldn't have the place ready by the time we got back from pursuing Herr Kruger all over the continent, but they came through for me.
Mm-hmm. So are you always so impulsive?
Pretty much so, till the last couple of years. So, how do you like the MYLES?
Well, there's just one thing.
Mm-hmm.
What does the MY stand for?
Maniac yuppie.
Oh, Kirk.
Magnificent. Yummy.
You silly bird.
It stands for motor yacht, which is what this boat is, even though she doesn't steam around Cape Horn anymore. Now, what's so funny?
Wait. You're telling me that you named the entire yacht and the restaurant after me?
I don't know anybody who deserves it more. As a matter of fact, I own the entire yacht club. I'm going to remodel the whole thing. You know, I was thinking, I've been living like a struggling junior executive, and I'm the executive VP of an international conglomerate. I mean, I want to enjoy all the fruits of my labors. And I want to enjoy them all with you. Come in, Charles.
Are you finished, sir?
Yes, we are. But we will have some more champagne, and you can hold off on the coffee and dessert until after we take a moonlight stroll around the deck of our yacht.
Thank you.
What?
It's just with all these incredible, wonderful surprises, we haven't really, got back to reality yet.
Don't worry about reality. Reality's right outside that door waiting to crash in on us anytime we want to let it, and I don't want to let it. So I'm going to keep the surprise and the romance coming. How's that sound?
It sounds lovely, but not too terribly realistic.
There's that word again.
Well, I'm glad your trip was so successful.
Oh, I don't know how successful it was. It was just nice to get away from Oakdale and all the memories here.
You know, we should have lunch soon. Why don't we do some catching up?
All right. Why don't you call me at the office, and we'll make a date.
Great.
Okay? See you later.
Well, I figured you got the message on your answering machine that I left you at the airport. Paul, I'm sorry that I wasn't able to come back with any news about your mother.
So am I. I just wish I knew what was going on with her. I mean, why she sounded so desperate on the phone.
Hey, believe me, you can drive yourself crazy thinking about that one. I know I have.
Duncan, you've been on the phone for a half an hour.
Aye, for the second time today with Beatrice. Have you spoken with Brian Whitley?
No, come to think of it, I haven't spoken with him in weeks. Oh, I hope nothing's wrong.
Well, I don't want to alarm you, but apparently they're having marital problems.
Come on, I can't believe that. Those two people are so much in love. They've got two adorable children.
They did seem very happy at our wedding in November.
Well, they certainly did. What could possibly be wrong?
Well, Beatrice didn't really want to discuss it, but there have been some minor tensions lately.
Oh, well, that happens in marriage, Duncan. You know, they can work that out.
Well, that's not all. Apparently, Brian was supposed to go to the continent for a few weeks on business and was supposed to return a few days ago, but called and said that he'd be detained. Beatrice broke down over the phone. She's afraid that there's another woman.
Oh, that's impossible. Brian would never do that.
I didn't really want to voice this, but Barbara and Brian were very much in love once.
Come on now, that was years ago.
Still, they could have run into each other in Europe. I wonder if I should voice my suspicions to Hal.
Oh, certainly not. Hal has enough on his mind. He is worried as it is. You're just letting your crazy imagination run away with itself.
Aye, Lisa, but you must admit it would account for Brian staying on the continent. And for Barbara saying it's too late.
What? Excuse me. Mona Lisa, may I help you?
Lisa, it's Bob.
Oh, Bob, any word about Andy?
I have some bad news for you, Lisa. Leanne's been in an automobile accident. She's in the ER at Memorial.
Oh, dear God, I'll be right there.
Come to the waiting room, right in front of the ER. See you soon. Lisa's on her way.
Oh. I keep thinking Leanne's just gonna walk here any second, like all this has been some kind of crazy mistake. I mean, how could this happen so fast? I just talked to her not even half an hour before the state police called Margot. Where's Pop?
He's just trying to get some information about Leanne. He'll be back.
Honey, sweetheart, I wish you would just sit down.
I can't. My daughter's in there. The only thing we know is that when the police found her, she was unconscious. She still hasn't regained consciousness.
Hi, I came as soon as I could. Leanne's going to be all right. She just has to be.
Well, I'm holding on to that. Nobody in here will tell me a damn thing.
All right, all right. I'll find out what I can.
Pop, how is she?
Painful wisdom teeth, aching molars. For these kinds of tough pains, see your dentist about the different medicine in Nuprin. You'll be surprised how well Nuprin handles your tough pain. Nuprin's not aspirin, not Tylenol, it's ibuprofen. Two Nuprin stop dental pain better than two extra strength Tylenol. And Nuprin's gentler on your stomach than aspirin. Nuprin. Little, yellow, different, better. It even works on your worst pain.
If you're trying to lose a few pounds and butter is out, you're gonna love this.
Molly McButter.
Now you can shake on the taste of butter for just 4 calories.
Molly McButter.
Molly McButter natural butter flavor sprinkles. The taste of real butter with only 4 calories per serving. A very wholesome 100% natural 4 little calories. So indulge yourself.
Molly McButter.
You've got Molly now.
How do Hershey's Kisses get that big chocolate taste into such a tiny package? Magic. Little Hershey's Kisses, big chocolate taste.
With McDonald's salad, you can travel light through your busy day when you want a bite. Have them at home or out by the pool. Fresh tossed salads, crisp and cool. At a game, on a boat, or on the run. You know, McDonald's salads, all dressed up and ready to go.
Clarence?
In the flesh, back from Genoa City with the scoop. John Abbott has a hot date.
You're kidding, right?
I'm not kidding. And Jack is irate.
All the women in the world! Jill!
I enjoy your father's company.
You stay away from my old man.
The young and the restless is wilder than ever.
Get ready for big laughs when Small Talk premieres Friday, May 4th.
Lisa, I'll drive you to the hospital. Okay?
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. I don't feel like driving tonight.
Don't worry. I'll take care of everything. Okay,
darling. Thank you. I'll call you as soon as I know.
Please. We'll be right back.
All right. Bye-bye.
Sure.
Leanne's been in an accident. She's over at Memorial.
What? We gotta get over there.
I'll go with you. Tom and Margo must be basket cases.
Okay. Oh, the send check. Them my best. No, I'll take care of it. Go.
I asked you to dinner.
You get it next time.
I'll
okay?
get it
Just
next
go.
Time.
God, things like this happen so quickly. I hope Leanne's gonna be all right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me too.
Emily.
Yeah?
I didn't want to press Hal about his search for Barbara. But did he find out anything at all?
No, not really. I tried to get information from Franco Visconti. All he would tell me was that he'd been in touch with her. I just have to wonder. He's such a womanizer. Maybe he's not cooperating for personal reasons.
Do you think that Barbara could be having an affair with another man?
I don't know. When she left Oakdale, she felt like she'd lost her husband and her son. She's pretty vulnerable. I'm sure she'd give in to someone who would comfort her.
Good evening, Mona Lisa. Hello, Kirk. I'm fine. How are you? Good. No, Lisa's not here right now. I'm sorry. Can I take a message?
Yeah, tell her she's a genius. The yacht's perfect. Ellie's still in shock. Come by anytime you want to and see for yourself. All right. Bye. Now, are you ready for your little moonlight stroll around the deck?
What about coffee and dessert?
We're gonna have that later. Somewhere else.
Where?
Did anyone ever tell you what happened to the curious cat?
Yeah, the one that swallowed the canary.
Wrong cat.
That's funny, because you look just like him right now.
Who?
The cat that swallowed the canary.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
You think that's because I'm with the most beautiful woman in Oakdale? Or maybe it's because I'm the proud owner of the MYLES. The yacht, that is, not the original. I would never try to own the original.
Kirk.
What?
I would be a liar if I said I wasn't enjoying every second of this. But I just want to know one thing.
What?
Where is this leading?
I don't know. I forgot my roadmap. You really that interested in final destinations? I mean, the way I see it, this can lead anywhere we want it to.
Leanne regained consciousness momentarily after they brought her in. The x-rays show 3 broken ribs, no other broken bones, but it appears to be internal bleeding.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Well, Bob, has anyone seen her?
The John took Tom and Margo in just a few minutes ago. They'll be bringing Leanne through. They're going to do a CAT scan.
Hi, John.
Duke. Oh, come on, now. Now, don't you worry. She's going to be just fine. Just remember all the things she's already survived.
Did you know that the car that hit Leanne was Duke's van?
What?
Yeah, it was stolen out of the driveway earlier tonight. Obviously, whoever took it was headed out of town on the Riverside Highway and tried to pass a car illegally and smashed right into Leanne's car head on.
Wait a minute, this is just... Oh, this is all unbelievable.
I know.
John said it was all right if I stay with Leanne all night.
Oh, that's great. Thanks a lot, Mama.
Completely that you were here. Oh, Miss
Lustrack. Hi, how's Leanne?
Well, she has some broken ribs and internal bleeding. Oh, please forgive me. I didn't mean to just run out of the restaurant without even telling you. It's just that I...
Tom?
Honey, oh, baby, I'm so sorry.
Oh. So help us alone, Mom.
Honey, you know, at least you got to see her only if it was for a few minutes.
We're gonna run a CAT scan, and we're hoping that it will show the causes of the internal bleeding.
Duke, I wish I had something to do or say. I'm so bad at times like this.
Well, who's good at times at this? I just wish I could have seen her, too. So damn,
is Detective Hughes here?
Oh, Detective Hughes. Yeah, she's right over there.
Sorry to intrude on you folks at a time like this, but I need some details for the accident report that went on your daughter's license or student ID.
I want to know what happened to the man that was driving the van that was stolen.
Sorry to say, it was a clear case of drunk driving. He's been taken to the Oakdale jail.
Well, good. As DA, I'm going to throw the book at him. I'm going to see that he is prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law.
Do we have a name?
Let's see. He's just a kid himself. He was really out of it on booze. Typically, he walked away without a scratch. Name is Andrew Dixon.
Your carpet is possessed by odors. They linger, haunting your house. New Love My Carpet Multifresh Potpourri drives them away. Its special combination of scents makes a variety of tough odors disappear. New Love My Carpet Potpourri. Odors don't stand a ghost of a chance.
Dull tiles will clear up when you put on a shining face. Your bathroom will cheer up when you put on a shining face.
Want clean that really shines? Lysol Basin Tub and Tile Cleaner lifts soap scum. Disinfects too. Lysol Basin Tub and Tile Cleaner. Now with an easy spray nozzle.
Put on a shining face.
Since Lauren arrived, life's been full of surprises. So I bought Lysol Cleaner to keep the house as clean as it can be. Cleaner. What really surprised me was its fresh lemon scent. Other cleaners can clean too, but most can't disinfect like Lysol.
Lysol deodorizing cleaner with a lemon fresh scent.
I like Lysol.
So you want to be a cook? Make it shine.
No fumes easy off oven cleaner is heat activated. So there are no gloves, no harsh fumes.
No smell?
And no grease.
Not bad, kid.
No fumes easy off, the easy way out of a dirty oven.
Adia Temporaries work for the best companies. They're confident because they know where they're going. And people pay attention to an Adia Temporary. Call Adia today, and you could be working tomorrow. Adia, temporary and permanent employment.
We'll continue with part two of As the World Turns in just a moment.
Two frightened children threatened by a dangerous intruder.
I was scared, really scared.
Their only lifeline, Rescue 911, Tuesday.
It's cause for laughter. It's cause for fun. It's cause on CBS.
All right.
It's Bill Cosby and Leonard Part 6, Tuesday.
This is CBS.
Announcing our newest arrival, new Nine Lives Kitten Dinners. They're just right for delicate digestive systems. Perfect for tiny teeth. With just the right vitamins and minerals these babies need to get off to a healthy start. New Nine Lives Kitten Dinners. 100% perfect nutrition, right from the start.
I think children should be seen and not heard.
This week, catch Princess Di in Paradise, investigate college crime, and see astounding UFOs on Hard Copy.
Tonight at 7 on 2.
Hi, I'm your conscience. No, really, I am. Listen,
I wouldn't give that to the kids if I were you.
You see, you expect a conscience to say no to things that taste extra good, but not anymore. Drake's Cakes, good as always, and better than ever. No tropical oils, low cholesterol, or even no cholesterol, and low sodium. So when the kids ask for a Drake's Cake, I can say, go for it, Mom. Is this gonna be fun or what?
How do police wives cope? Married to cops, love in the line of duty. I'm the next Robin. Today at 4.
And now part two of As the World Turns.
Are you sure?
Positive.
Oh, did you actually talk to
him?
Oh,
so no, ma'am, I didn't. That wasn't
Honey, here she is. Is he in there? Honey, there she is.
Please, let us through, folks. Hey, I'm right here, babe. I'm not going anywhere.
I think maybe we better go over to the jail.
Don't you think you should wait to see Andy until
we... We can't.
All right, then I'll go with you.
Honey, no, you're needed here. It's all... Mom, you want me to come along? No, honey, thank you.
Look, I think we can handle it.
Now, Bob, I know how you must feel, but just don't, okay?
I don't envy Pop and Kim having to face Andy right now after all this. If I saw his face right now, I'd tear him apart.
I know how you feel about Leanne, but you should still have some sympathy for Andy.
Sympathy? For what? You know, he knew the alcohol was poisoning him, and everybody, including me, tried to get him to snap out of it, but he just didn't have the courage to face it. The only person I feel sorry for right now is Leanne. She never has to be hurt.
I still feel sorry for Andy.
You hardly know him. How could you feel anything?
I wonder if Andy has any idea at all how many people he's hurt.
Oh, no. Wish there was something I could do to help.
You have just by being here. Daddy, should I call Grandma and Max?
Oh, honey, let's wait until we know more, okay?
Okay.
Thank you for your help. I hope your daughter pulls through.
Oh, thank you.
I still can't believe that Andy was driving out of the car.
Yeah, neither can I.
What is wrong with you people? Andy's been on a downhill course of self-destruction for months. How can you feel? Leanne's the one that's suffering, not him.
Son, why don't you go down to the cafeteria, and then I'll call you if there's anything...
I'm not going anywhere, Dad. I'm just praying that the CAT scan shows why she's bleeding inside. Did you see her? They wheeled her.
All right. Son, she's in good hands with Phelan, believe me.
Where's Emily?
Well, she wanted to come over when she heard the news at the Mona Lisa, but she said she wanted to get in touch with her mom first.
Paul, would Emily still be at the restaurant?
I'm not really sure why.
I want to talk to her about something. Excuse me. This is Dr. Hughes calling. Is Emily Stewart still there by any chance?
Aha! Sorry about that. Avast, matey, open your eyes.
Where are we?
This is the old bridge of the yacht that I had redesigned and refurbished by Shannon. And these are going to be our living quarters.
Get out of here.
I'm serious.
No, you're not.
I am too.
You are not.
Now, look at this so you can see for yourself that this boat has been, in fact, rechristened.
No.
Yep.
Put me down.
Nope.
Put me down.
Nope. Only if you promise that you will share this space with me.
What if I say no?
Well, then I'll just have to pull the plug on the whole boat. We'll go down to the bottom of the river.
You wouldn't do that.
Oh, yes, I would. I'm impulsive. You know that.
It's pretty apparent that you're impulsive, so don't forget that.
I won't.
Put me down.
All right. There you go. Now, I'm going to show you the rest of the place later. But now, we have some coffee and some champagne to consume, and then we're going to throw our glasses overboard.
Is that a nautical tradition, Captain Kirk?
I have no idea. I'm a landlubber, so I say we make our own set of traditions as we go along. How's that sound?
I'll drink to that.
Not quite yet, you won't, because I have one more surprise.
No, no,
come
no,
over here.
Too many.
Let's see.
You're crazy.
Yep. You like?
I love.
A little corny, but kind of jaunty, if you know what I mean. Now, what kind of a reward am I going to get for all of this effort?
Well, that depends on what kind of reward that you want.
This will do for starters.
Another hot day. Make sure you have plenty of something.
Hey, what are you doing?
When it comes to 100% instant iced tea refreshment, more people choose Nestea over any other. Take the Nestea plunge.
A good breakfast. Here, try new oatmeal crisp.
Your mom harangues me enough about what's good for me.
But Dad, this one really tastes good.
Taste what they've done to my oatmeal.
Introducing Oatmeal Crisp, real honest to good for you oatmeal in a big crisp flake with a delicious taste of almonds and a touch of brown sugar.
Cindy, be sure to tell Mom about this.
Dad!
New Oatmeal Crisp and original Oatmeal Raisin Crisp. Two ways to taste what we've done to oatmeal.
Look at me, enjoying corn on the cob, thanks to Super Poly Grip. With dentures, I thought I'd have to give up corn on the cob. But thanks to Super Poly Grip, I still enjoy my favorite food.
While denture wearers can't eat everything, Super Poly Grip forms a seal that holds dentures tight.
Look at me, enjoying corn.
Thanks to Super Poly Grip, many denture wearers enjoy more of their favorite foods.
No, I had no idea that my mother was on vacation. That's why I haven't been able to get in touch with her.
Emily, I don't mean to alarm you, but I'm concerned about your mother. She put in for 2 weeks vacation from John without saying anything to you, to me, or to Casey. I find that very strange.
Bob, do you think she's back on the pills again?
I don't know. We've seen some signs recently, but she denies it.
Well, what about Dr. Matthews? Did you talk to him?
He hasn't heard from her either.
Okay, I'm going to stop by her apartment. I'll see if I can find any clues about where she might have gone.
I'll appreciate that.
All right, I'm going to come by the hospital. Anyway, I want to check up to see how Leanne is doing. I was very shocked to find out about Andy's involvement in that.
We all were. Kim and John went over to the jail to see Andy.
I hope everything's all right with Leanne. I'll see you later. Bye. Did Dr. Hughes have any news about Leanne? Well, they're investigating to see what's causing the internal bleeding. I was just shocked to find out about Andy's involvement. He was driving Duke's van while intoxicated. He's the one who caused the
bloody
accident.
Hell.
Oh, my God. Is he all right? He's in jail. He's got some pretty serious charges pending. Look, I got to go to the hospital anyway, so I'll let you guys know if I have hear any news, all right?
I'll walk you to your car.
Thank you, Doctor.
Good night, Emily.
Good night. Caleb, what's going to happen to Andy?
I don't know, but it's not your responsibility anymore.
Well, how do you stop feeling responsible for somebody that you were really close to at one time? You know what? It's partially my fault that he's drinking again.
You keep saying that, but I don't understand why.
Well, he was still in love with me when I moved out on him, and it's just his life just went to pieces after that.
Look, actually, you know, I think I should call Mama. She's going to want to know this news.
Caleb, why don't you just go ahead and tell her in person?
I was going to drive you home after you got off.
No, Sam, I don't know what time Lisa's going to get back here tonight. It could be late, and I know you have to get up at the crack of dawn tomorrow.
Well, so. I'm going to hate to leave you.
I'll be fine.
No, actually, I could go by Kirk's place and see how Ellie's doing.
That's a good idea.
I'll miss you.
I miss you, too.
I'll miss you more. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Good night, Doc.
Night, Killer. You know, Julie, seeing you like that with your husband makes me miss Shannon all the more.
I'm sure she's just as lonely as you are, Duncan.
I'm still in shock about Leanne and Andy.
You and me both. Oh, you've been drinking!
I had a little eggnog, so what?
You had a lot more than a little bit, I know why.
Because I got a lot to celebrate, right? I got the girl of my dreams. She's gonna be a big model someday, you know? All the kids in school are gonna envy me. Man, well, I should just quit school. You can get me a job as your private photographer.
Stop it! I know you found out about the necklace.
I don't want to talk about it.
Listen, listen to me. You got it wrong, okay? You don't know. It's not what you think.
Oh, what could I possibly think, Julie? A guy takes you to New York and lands you a big modeling job.
Andy, it's all legitimate.
Right, right. Yeah, that's why you've been coming home late every night. That's why that sleaze gives you a check every week. And that necklace that I couldn't afford.
No, you got it all wrong.
Whoa, right, right. My imagination's running wild. You know, it seems to me like you're...
Oh, Andy. If I'm responsible for this, how am I supposed to live with it? Dr. Phelan said he'll be out shortly, okay?
Oh, God. Wish I could be in there and go through this with her. She looks so helpless and alone. I missed her for 16 years, and now I can't help her again. God.
Dick, what did the CAT scan show?
I'm afraid it's what we suspected. The X-ray showed 3 broken left ribs, and there's also evidence of a subcapsular hematoma on the spleen.
What does that mean?
The sac around the spleen is swollen from internal bleeding.
She's being prepped for surgery right now. I'll let you know as soon as she's out of OR.
Thanks, Dick.
Does that mean they have to remove Leanne's spleen? Oh, man. I wish Andy was here right now instead of jail so he could see all the suffering he's caused firsthand.
Now, I'm sure he's suffering, too.
Not nearly enough.
You've got 10 minutes with your parents, Dixon.
I know how you must feel, but you gotta believe me, I'm so sorry.
Andrew, we didn't come down here to listen to a lot of empty words.
We certainly didn't. Save that for Leanne.
Well, what's Leanne got to do with this?
She was driving the car you smashed into tonight. At the moment, she's at Memorial, fighting for her life.
I remember when I was a young man, my father telling me about the Acoma Indians. Their culture and history were one of America's greatest glories. Well, now I got the time to see it for myself. Of course, affording it's another matter. I wasn't sure I could make it, but AARP helped with discounts on hotels, motels, even the car I rented. So here I am. And you know what? My father was right.
AARP, making a difference.
For over 80 years, Murphy's Oil Soap has cleaned all kinds of wood in all kinds of houses. But is it good enough to tackle this house? Murphy's, the pure natural cleaner that's safe to use on almost any wooden surface, can stand up to the toughest test and pass with flying colors. If Murphy's Oil Soap is good enough to clean Sigma Delta, it's surely good enough to clean your house. It's 5 p.m. Do you know what you're paying on AT&T? With MCI Primetime, you'd know exactly. $8 a month for an hour of calls starting at 5. One price, all evening, all over the country. AT&T could cost $15.
Hello, MCI. I'd like to order your Primetime plan.
Now that you know, call for MCI's Primetime plan.
Interested in a better hand soap? Not me.
I can go. I don't need no lava soap, no.
Regular soap won't always work, but lava with hummus will. Interested?
No, no, no.
Lava, the don't try to cope without it soap.
They're coming. Dow Bathroom Cleaner with scrubbing bubbles. It's 50% stronger than original Dow Bathroom Cleaner. We work even harder. So you don't have to.
You're making this up to make me feel worse.
No, we're not making it up. We're not lying to you. That seems to be your expertise. When we left the hospital, Leanne was suffering from internal bleeding, and she was half conscious.
I have to get to the hospital.
Andy, you're not going anywhere. You have become what is called a public menace. And if Leanne doesn't make it, you could be guilty of manslaughter.
I don't care about myself. I've got to get to the hospital.
So you can see Tom, the depths of despair, praying that his daughter will live? Or all the other people who love Leanne are trying to make some sense of the fact that someone that they've loved and respected is responsible for stealing this van and using it to maim and mutilate, maybe even murder?
You know, I think Tom or Duke might just go for your throat if they saw you anywhere near the hospital, and I can't say that I would really blame them. But maybe it would be a good thing for you to go down to the hospital and take a look at all the sorrow and the grief and the rigmarole that you've caused with your selfishness. On the other hand, it might be good to stay right here in jail so that you get a good idea of what the next few years of your life could be like.
I can't blame you for feeling this way or saying these things, but you gotta help me. Mom, you gotta help me. Mom?
Why? Because you're my son? What are we supposed to do, forget about all the lies you've told and the crime you've committed? That's not important? Oh, no, no, of course not. That's not important. What's really important in your life right now is alcohol. Never mind about the people you've hurt and the lives. These are lives you are playing around with, you and your stupid alcohol.
I find it kind of strange, Andrew, that you should be asking for our help now, after you've done nothing but reject our help for the past few months. I'll tell you, Andy, it's been a little like hell. You know, we're covering for your bad checks. We're apologizing to these strangers, total strangers, for your selfish acts. But there's got to come a time, Andy, when even your parents say, that's it. We've had enough. And I think that's where your mother and I are right now. We offer you our love. We offer you our help. Both of these things you throw right back in our face. We talk to people who are experts on your disease, and they tell us that our help doesn't matter unless you want to help yourself. Well, I believe that finally. But Andy, I don't think you want to help yourself. You want to destroy your life, and now you're taking along a lot of innocent people with you.
I do want to help myself. Dad, I want to detox.
How long is that going to last, do you suppose? I mean, you're afraid now, and you've got every good reason to be afraid. But when that's over, what then? Does this whole thing start all over again?
No!
Your mother and I don't believe a word you say, Andy, and it's not because we don't want to. It's because of your track record. We won't. We can't.
This is very tough stuff. Accepting the fact that our son is guilty of a criminal act. How do we get through that? In spite of everything that you've done, I still love you. But loving you doesn't change what you've done. And we have got to let you go. And you have got to face the consequences of the laws you have broken. I pray with all of my heart that Leanne pulls through. Even if she does, you are going to have to spend the rest of your life knowing you could just as well have killed her on the spot. I don't envy you that.
Your mother and I are going back to the hospital.
What's gonna happen to me?
It's up to the authorities now.
The police tell us that we could get you a lawyer. We could go before a judge. We could post bail, and you could be released. But your mother and I have decided that we're not gonna do that.
I would suggest that you spend the time here taking a long, hard look at your life. Look at me! Stop hiding behind lies and empty promises. Find out if you've got the courage to be honest with yourself.
Hey, who's coming for dinner? Princess Di?
No, just some guy with no soccer tonight.
What are we celebrating?
A daughter with no gymnastics tonight, and a husband with no meeting tonight.
The Joy Shine always shows you care. Joy's clean rinsing formula removes dishwater film and rinses so brilliantly, nothing's left on dishes but the shine.
Laura, I thought it was just you and me tonight.
It is.
Nothing dishes out a brighter shine than clean rinsing Joy.
I'm taking care of Ernie, Mommy.
And I'm taking care of you. Here's your Sesame Street vitamin.
Ernie!
My kids like Sesame Street vitamins for the character shapes and the natural fruit flavors and colors. But I like them because they're age-formulated, so Kevin and his big sister each get 100% of the vitamins they need every day. How can I give them less than 100%?
Sesame Street vitamins, age-formulated for 100% every day.
Roaches live inside walls where you have to go to kill them. That's why Combat Discs, now with more roach-killing insecticide, use roaches to kill roaches. Look, roaches enter the Combat Disc and take the lethal bait back into the walls where they live, where other roaches share the poison and die. Control roaches where they live. Combat, because where they live is where they die.
Well, Caleb, what do you think?
Well, Kirk, I must say, I'm wondering how much it all cost.
Oh, it cost a bundle. What's money for, huh? Oh,
It's a new intercom. Yeah. Okay, I'll be right there. Right. Well, tomorrow is the grand opening of Ellie's restaurant, so the maitre d' and the staff are doing a dress rehearsal. They want me to check it out, so I will be right back.
Okay. So, Caleb, what do you really think?
Ellie? I don't know. But I guess what's important is how you're handling it all.
Well, I love it. I love it. I'm a little overwhelmed.
Yeah, I could see how you'd be a little dazzled by it all. Are you ready to go public with this relationship with Kirk?
What do you mean?
Well, isn't it obvious? I mean, you have a yacht and a restaurant that's named after you. Everybody in town's gonna know that Kirk's responsible. It's like putting up the biggest billboard in Oakdale saying you're Kirk's mistress. How do you think the family or Iva's gonna react to all this?
Leanne is still in surgery, but there's nothing new to report.
Tom looks really devastated.
Yeah. Did you stop by your mother's apartment?
Yeah, I did. There's not a clue to where she might have gone. There's some clothes missing. There's a suitcase missing. Her car is gone. I'm going to call the travel agent tomorrow and see if she has any idea where she might have gone.
Good. You let me know.
I will. Bob, thanks for caring about my mom. Look, guys, I'm so tired. I'm starting to see double. I bet you feel the same way, Hal.
Yeah, you could say that.
Why don't you both go home, get some sleep, and I'll call if there's any news.
Okay, thanks. Hey, Emily, since I had the only car, how did you get here?
Taxi. Oh,
taxi. You want a lift?
Yeah, thanks.
Can I see you guys later.
See you. Hey, guys, if there's any reason that you want me to stay, I'll stay.
No, actually, I think it would be best if you went home and got some rest in case I'm not in tomorrow.
Okay.
Franny.
Hi, Mom.
My girl, listen, would you mind going home and relieving Joyce? She wanted to leave by 10 o'clock.
Yeah, sure. Just call me if there's any news, okay?
I'll drive you. I have to drive Courtney home anyway.
All right. Thank you.
What happened with Annie?
We told him about Leanne. We decided to leave him in jail. Maybe he'll start to face his responsibilities.
Dr. Phelan, how's my little girl?
I know I'm probably the last person you wanted to see, but I just had to come and tell you how sorry I am. See if there's anything I can do.
I appreciate it. How's Leanne?
I don't know. Lisa was supposed to call me from the hospital, but when I left to come here, I hadn't heard from her.
I can't believe it. How'd you get in here?
They were only gonna let family, and so I told them that I was your wife. You sure there's nothing I can do to help?
I really don't think there's anything anybody can do at this point. My folks have turned their back on me.
Oh, no. I can't believe that.
Yeah, well, you should have seen her. I'd never seen my mom like that before. It's weird, you know, all we've been through. You're the one to come and offer me help.
Maybe I still feel responsible somehow.
Oh, I'm through with that. I'm through blaming other people for the mess that I made in my life.
Andy, you're gonna beat this thing. You will.
Julie, on second thought, there is something that you can do for me. My dad told me about this doctor that runs a private clinic. His name is Matthews, Henry Matthews.
Okay.
Would you mind calling him for me? I mean, I'm in trouble. I need to tell him I need to see him, okay?
Yes, I will. I'll call him as soon as I get back to the Mona Lisa.
Thank you.
God, I just hate seeing you in this awful place.
This is where I belong.
No, that's not true. You know, with all the good things that have happened in my life, I can never be completely happy until I know that you are. I have you to thank for the good things in my life. I have to go. I'm sorry.
Thanks, Julie.
save your sorry for Leanne. She's the one fighting for her life right now.
Shower fresh feeling with new, even wider Band Solid. Now Band glides on extra wide for even wider coverage. New Band Solid, now wider than ever.
Ooh, keep that shower fresh feeling all day.
Ernie, don't take the game.
It's my categories, and I'm going home.
Don't let him go.
Give in on neatness.
All right, we accept neatness.
Neatness as a disease?
Yes.
Scattergories. A letter comes up on the dice, and there's all these categories. And you think of a word for each that starts with that letter. But your answer can't be like anyone else's.
Beginning with R, farm animals.
Rhinoceros.
Rhinoceros.
Categories from Milton Bradley. It's better to have your own.
Lots of traffic on your carpet? Well, it doesn't need to show it. Woolite Deep Cleaning Carpet Cleaner. It's specially formulated to get out tough, ground-in dirt. No fooling. Woolite. It's serious cleaning.
For something light, may we suggest a cool McDonald's salad. Toss fresh, they go to work, to your home, to the park, to the beach. Crisp, delicious salads right in reach. Fresh tossed salads from McDonald's. Oh yeah, all dressed up and ready to go.
The Major's favorite medal is lost.
AC took your father's Purple Heart.
Will his punishment fit the crime?
You have anything to say?
Are you going to shoot me?
Major Dad. Then it's a case of mistaken identity.
This is Sydney.
But is she man enough to handle it?
He thinks I'm a him?
An all-new Sydney after Major Dad, tonight. Kids speak out, from parents...
Just get them out of the house.
...to presidents.
All you do is you sit down.
It's Big Laughs when Small Talk premieres Friday, May 4th.
Stay tuned for Guiding Light, next on most of the CBS stations. By Monet. Join us tomorrow for As the World Turns.